Yeah. Hey guys, so we're here with the team, and
am I part of the team?
Well, you're right here. You're handing out sandwiches. And we Jessie's there. I don't know why she's not behind me, so we just got done with about four city blocks, I think, something like that. And there is so much. There are so much. It is miles and miles of tents and homeless people and different things on the streets here. Just miles and miles of it. And we just went a little ways. We handed out sandwiches. Hey, Ruth. Wish you were here, Ruth. And loved on people. I would say, so the sandwiches are the bait. People ain't going to stop and talk to you unless you have something here. So the sandwich is the bait. And I would say for every 10 sandwiches we hand out.
He's asking if he can have
it. Yeah, yeah. Right there. Well, you already gave me. So probably for every 10 sandwiches we hand out, we're able to pray for one person. A lot of people don't want prayer. They don't want it mainly because we're on 5th and Crocker Street every Saturday morning. Hey, yeah, message me. I won't be here this Saturday.
Yeah, but she already messaged me.
But I will be here next Saturday. So, message me and we'll come out with the team. Oh, Ruth, we just speak healing on your body right now in Jesus' name.
On those wisdom teeth. Shine.
Bam. Hey, Mike. Brother Mike, I love Mike so much. My wife's watching. Hey, wife. Hey, it's
hey,
one
Mom.
Of the Rubios.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Mom.
That's what I'm saying. You got to bait him. Hey, Jennifer. So anyway, it's about every 10 sandwiches we get to pray for somebody. It's kind of what we see. That's across the board. That's no matter where we're at, LA, San Francisco, Kansas City, no matter where I've been. Not everybody wants prayer. You know, they've been down here for years and years a lot of times, and they've just, you know, everybody wants to pray for them. And the way they see it is, you know, prayer is cheap, talk's cheap. And there's a whole lot of intricate things with that whole web, you know, where, you know, a lot of times they do, you know, they just don't want help and different things. So there are many different aspects to it. But Neil, what did you think?
It's rough down here, you know. Just driving down here, we went through miles and miles and miles of just tents just across the road. And even just driving on the interstate, there's bypasses above us that had just tents on the bypasses. I mean, these people aren't out here because it's, you know, it's fun, you know. It's like, they're...
Hey, you want a sandwich, brother?
Huh?
You want a sandwich?
Yeah. What'd you say after?
It's PB.
Brother?
Oh, I thought you said Brian. I go, he knows my name?
Yeah.
PB&J, you want some
go.
Prayer, brother? You want any prayer?
Yeah, for my spine, man.
Yep.
For your spine?
Yep.
Let me pray for you.
See that? Bam, he wants prayer. Thank you, Lord. Bam. Bam, bam, bam. Thank you, Lord. Can I send a sandwich to Australia? Yes. Hey, Trip, what's up, brother? Thank you. Thank you, Lord. So anyway, so Jennifer, tell me what, give me your feedback.
Me personally, it's a culture shock. I'm from Kansas City, and so we see homelessness. In Kansas City, but not as much. It's like every strip that we walk down, every corner, every person, it was heartbreaking because you see all these tents, and I've never seen like the trash cans being overflowing the way they were.
Nice walk.
And just feces.
Have a nice day.
Everything. It just really broke my heart to the point that there were times I just wanted to walk away because it just really broke my heart. More so that people weren't even, it was like they were just invisible. And we saw like a lot of missions, like a lot of ministries or missions that are actually planted here. And I don't really see them doing anything except for people probably going in there just to get a free meal and that's it. But I know there's more, you know. I don't want to get too much into it, so.
Jesse, tell them what you think. You got to come over here.
Honestly, it's really heartbreaking to be out here. Just because, one, seeing the situation that a lot of people have been forced into, as well as seeing almost the quality of lifestyle that people have become accustomed to. Because it's like my father said, some people do want it, and some people are okay with it. And it's sad to see that that's the kind of thing that, I don't know, is just normal for them.
Donna, can't. They don't have homelessness in Canada. They have igloos for people.
They have maple. They hand out maple.
I'm just kidding. You try to make a little light of it, but there are people down here that are doing amazing things. They are, you know. it's just so many. You know, it really is an atmosphere that has to be changed. And this, you know, it's not just in L.A., it's everywhere we go. You know, I've been in this ministry, doing this kind of ministry for 15 years, almost 20 years. And it's the same everywhere. So, what do you think, Demetrius? Yeah, what do you think?
I love it. I love doing the street ministry and giving out to people, the conversations, you know, just making somebody else's day better, you know. I love it. It's just like a breath of fresh air, you know. It's very, the atmosphere around here is very oppressive, but, you know, you just have to think about Jesus. And that made things, you know, a lot better.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Well, guys, love you. Love everybody that's watching. Love everybody that, you know, gave to sandwiches and making stuff. And hey, you guys want a sandwich? You want a sandwich?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. Are you allergic? So.
Yeah.
So anyway, God bless you guys. In Jesus' name, amen.